Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Oreo truffles, and it's going to be a great holiday recipe. I'm trying to do a few for you, whether you're doing them for Thanksgiving, which is still coming up. For some of you, when you watch this later, it won't be. Or if you're doing it for Christmas, or if you have parties to go to that you want to take something that is a real treat, then I think you'll like these Oreo truffles. And it's very simple because it only has about three ingredients. One of the main ingredients is Oreo cookies. And I will tell you that this recipe was given to me by Jessica B98. So thank you, Jessica, for the recipe. It sounds great. And what I'm doing with the recipe is taking one half of each ingredient, because this will make quite a few, I would say. And Rick and I are going to be eating very well through this holiday season, and we don't want to have too much around here, not too much temptation. Although I'm sure these freeze very well, and we could have one or two and then freeze the rest and just have them for the next few months. So what you're going to need is a package of Oreo cookies, and these are the normal stuffing. You don't want to get the double stuffed kind. This is a little over a pound's worth, so when you're picking yours out, there are actually, 14 per row in here. There'd be 42 in here, so I had to get 21. So you'll notice that my mixture might be a little smaller than yours if you go by the regular recipe, and I will write it up as Jessica's normal recipe. So what you're going to do is take your amount of Oreo cookies, which might be the whole bag, or just this is the half of the bag, and you're going to put them in a food processor. And what you're going to do is process this until you have very fine crumbs. Okay, got that going, and we're ready to go. It's going to make noise, so I'll probably be going away and coming back to show you the crumbs. We're all finished with the processing of our Oreos, and we have very fine crumbles. One thing that will happen is there may be an Oreo here or there that will just kind of fly around and not really get into the mix. Just pick that out at the end instead of processing forever. So take this to a bowl where you can mix some things together. Just get this out. It's a little messy. It's kind of like working with dirt, but like I said, not too many items to have to deal with. So we'll just put that aside. And then I want to show you what I have here. This is cream cheese, and it's full fat cream cheese. It's not fat free. And Jessica told me in her email that we should not use the fat-free variety because that's too soft. And it's going to be important when you form these balls that they stay together. So if you have the fat-free cream cheese, it won't work. So this is just regular cream cheese. It is one half of that block. That's an 8-ounce block. You'll use it all if you're using the full recipe. But I just have 4 ounces here because I'm just doing half of the recipe. So we're going to be mixing this together. And I will use the fork to mash it, the spoon to stir it, whatever it needs to get that together. And I'll just get started right now. But I'm sure I will have to go away and get it completed and come back and show you. It's kind of sticking to the spoon, so I'll go to the fork. This is much better. But it's going to take a little bit of time for me to get this. I want it to the point where I can make balls of it. These are going to be truffles. They're going to be dipped in chocolate. And we need something that is a small ball. So let me come back when I have it ready to make into balls. I have my Oreo mixture all together, and you can see that what it looks like. I used the fork for a while, and then I finally just decided to use my hands to get it together like this. So if you need to do that, that's fine, because you're going to be putting these into balls. Now Jessica suggested that you use a melon baller. That makes them all the same size. And these are small. Actually, I have broken my melon baller, so I'm just doing these by hand. But that was a good option that she mentioned. What you're going to do is make these into hopefully equally sized balls, and then put them on wax paper. The next step will be to put them in the refrigerator for 1 hour. So I'm going to go away and finish this. When I come back, these will have been refrigerated. We'll be ready to coat them with chocolate. Here I have my truffles straight from the refrigerator, and you can see there are 4 in this direction, 5 in this direction. I got 20. I had the impression from Jessica that they would probably be smaller if you use the melon baller, so you would probably expect to have more if you make them tinier. The size is really just going to be up to you. It depends on how much you want to have when you take a bite of it. The next thing I need to do is to melt some chocolate. And we have some semi-sweet chocolate chips. This is a 12-ounce bag, which I just opened. And since I'm doing half a recipe, I'm only using half a bag. So that would be 6 ounces that I'm going to put in the top of the double boiler. Now, Jessica's method is to use the microwave. And I'm just so used to using a double boiler, I'm going to use that. But I may ride it up using the microwave. One thing she did emphasize is that when you have it all melted, which you'll melt it in the microwave, and then you can put it over a bowl of hot water, you can tilt the chocolate, and if you go up toward the top, it will have a thin coating. If you go toward the bottom to do your dipping, you'll have a thick coating. So you might want to take that into consideration. One thing I like to do is to put some paraffin in. Some of you may not like to do that. Maybe you think it's harmful. I don't. And professional candy making usually has, if it's coated like this, it has some paraffin, so it will make a nicer finish to it. And you put about 1/10 as much as you have of your coating. So for 6 ounces, it would be 0.6 ounces, less than, or a little more than a 1/2 ounce of paraffin. And you see how quickly this does dissolve? I'm going to work on it a little bit. I have to particularly get that paraffin melted, and we'll come back and start dipping. I have my chocolate chips and paraffin melted together right here. And I turned the heat off if it seems to be solidifying any at all or causing me any trouble, then I'll turn the heat back on. But it's easier to work over the top of this if you have the heat off. So we go to one of our Oreo truffles, and it's going to get dipped, so I'm going to just place it in one of the 2 spoons. I like to use 2 iced teaspoons, and that allows me to bring some of this up and let it flow over the top, or I could put that down inside it, either way. But I want it covered, and then I don't want any excess, so I use the 2 spoons and make sure I get everything covered. But with the 2 spoons, I can sort of get any extra spaces covered that appear, and I can also shake off any of the extra that I don't need. Then I'll bring it back over here, and if I need that extra spoon, I'll use it. And there generally will be a little bit around the bottom. You can use the knife after it dries and cut that off. But these will all be coated like that, and then I'll put them in the refrigerator to let them set up. You can serve them cool, or you can serve them at room temperature. At room temperature, they're going to be a little bit softer, so it's your choice. I like to eat truffles and bourbon balls and those peanut butter bonbons that I made for you recently. I like to eat them frozen, but that's just a matter of preference. So I'll get these done and show you what they're like when they're finished. And here we have our finished Oreo truffles. They look wonderful. And I would like to say thank you again to Jessica B98 for sending me the recipe. When I got the recipe, I showed it to my daughter, and my daughter had made the recipe or something of that nature. I don't know that it was exactly the same recipe, but it was for Oreo truffles, and highly recommended it. So that's one reason it made it into Betty's kitchen. I knew it would be good, and it just sounded good anyway. But I would like to say thank you for taking the time and effort to type all of that out, because I know how hard it is to keep up with a lot of recipes. I expect this will be gone before we know it, but it's a good start to the holiday season, and if I have guests over, then they will be delighted to see something like this. Thank you, Jessica, and I hope everyone enjoys this.